Hey guys, welcome back to Digit.in, and today we have with us the Google Pixel 2 XL smartphone, which starts at 73,000 rupees and is equipped with the state-of-the-art hardware driven by artificial intelligence and machine learning. But is the world, and especially India, ready for a device like this? Let's find out. We must admit that we are somewhat disappointed with this device, and as it was last year, we are not sold on many of Google's decisions. Let's first talk about the screen burn-in issues. The review unit we have hasn't shown the problem yet, despite keeping still images on the screen for hours on end. For us, the larger problem is how the colors are represented on the screen. Google says it's working on a software fix for this problem, but we don't see that helping with the poor viewing angles of this phone. Flagship or not, a phone in 2017 should not be showing a blue tint from off angles, especially when they are not even acute angles. You can turn on night light and turn its intensity to low, which is a temporary fix. It will make the display yellowish when viewed up front, but it looks whiter from angles. Let's not talk about other terms like sRGB or DCI-P3, as they make no sense to the consumers. What matters most is the presence of undersaturated colors on the display, which gives a gloomy and hazy day look instead of warm and sunny. We also don't like the big bezels on the Pixel 2 XL. It has an 18:9 aspect ratio display, and yet it is unnecessarily wide. That makes the Pixel 2 XL unwieldy and difficult to use. Since most videos or movies will not support 18:9 right now, they are already pillar boxed. But the Pixel 2 XL's large bezels make them look like they are pillar boxed as well. Otherwise, this is a well-built smartphone with the aluminium casing that feels strong and sturdy. The back is aluminium with a plastic-like textured finish on about 3/4 of it. The top fourth is glass for improved antenna performance, with a slightly protruding camera module placed here. The fingerprint sensor lies below this, centered for where your finger will be falling naturally. Due to the Pixel XL's form factor, you will have to shift your grip to reach the power button on its right. The volume rocker rests under your thumb, but the power button is placed nearer to the top. Google skipped the headphone jack this time and has provided a USB Type-C to 3.5mm dongle in the box. Let's talk about the camera. The 12.2-megapixel sensor on the back, accompanied by Google's AI and machine learning mumbo-jumbo, makes for an impressive shooter. First things first, the camera on the Pixel 2 XL captures great amount of details in the images clicked. The photos do look dull on the phone's own display, but they can truly wow you otherwise. Google's algorithms are somehow good enough to manage color differentiation even in shadow areas on low-light shots, something phones like Galaxy Note 8 promptly ignore. The Pixel 2 XL's camera is designed to put a nail in the point-and-shoot coffin once and for all. Though the phone does that, it doesn't necessarily improve on point-and-shoot cameras. That's because the Pixel 2's camera is finicky. You can either capture some great-looking photos or end up getting absolutely average shots. The camera also messed up with the white balance. For instance, the photo of the piano is clicked under halogen lights, and the Pixel 2 XL produced lots of noise here. Similarly, in the second photograph, it produces blue light between the trees, whereas the original scene had only regular fluorescent street lamps. Google is making a real statement with the portrait mode on the Pixel 2 XL. The phone has a single sensor on the back and front each, but there is portrait mode on either side. The fact that Google could accomplish this was a feat in itself, and we must commend its efforts. Being entirely dependent on software, the Pixel 2s can often falter with how they blur the background. You will sometimes find patches behind your subject that are not blurred properly. At other times, it will sharpen the subject unnaturally. YouTubers and those who shoot lots of videos with their phones will drool at the Pixel 2 XL. The phone offers impressive stabilization, just like last year's Pixel. The Pixel 2 XL has an excellent camera, and we stand by that. But we would warn you against expecting excellent shots all the time. It's a fact that Android phones slow down over time. Believe it or not, Pixel 2 XL will too. But it's fast out of the box. The Snapdragon 835 is the fastest processor you can find, and the phone powers through almost everything you can throw at it. App load times are the lowest Android can offer today, and lags and frame drops are non-existent. For those wondering, the Pixel 2 XL also comes on the top of benchmarks. And yes, it is not as powerful as the 2017 iPhones on paper. But during regular usage, the smartphone is smooth and fluid. Google promises a day's worth of battery life, and we concur with the same. However, we could get noticeably higher battery life from the Galaxy Note 8. So finally, the question is, should you purchase the Pixel 2 XL? Well, the smartphone is fast, but not the fastest. It has a disappointing display, a great but inconsistent camera, and average battery life. At 73,000 rupees, that does not make a very good value proposition. It is for sure a functional and even a good smartphone, but we are not sure that's enough at this price. You could still buy the Pixel 2 XL for its excellent camera, but personally, we are not convinced by it. So what do you think about this review? Comment down below and don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks for watching.